Hi, very good evening to all. My name is Bhavana. I hope all are good. And our subject is foreign trade. This is for BCom first years in first semester for general students only. Previous lecture we discussed our third unit, that is Indian trade policy. In this Indian trade policy, we discuss some concepts. They are: what is an Indian trade policy? What is the need for the Indian trade policy? Exports of Indian trade policy and its objectives, imports of Indian trade policy and its objectives, and objectives of complete Indian trade policy. Today we are discussing what are the importances and implementations of trade policy. Our concept, today concept, is importance and implementation of the trade policy. What is the importance and why we need to implement the trade policy? Let's see here. Trade policy of a country refers to the set of policies which govern the external sector of the economy. Trade means is nothing but exchange of goods from one place to another place. Means here one country to another country. So it comes under the external factors. Internal factors means within the country. But we are exporting our goods from one country to another country. So we can say it is an external sector of its economy. Trade policy of a country refers to the set of policies which govern the external sector of its economy. In a developing country like India, while we are taking in India, trade policy is one of the economic instrument. Trade policy means exchange of goods from one country to another country is one of the economic instruments which are used to suit the requirements of economic growth. While our country want to improve our economy, so we have to concentrate on trade. Means we want to export goods from other countries. In this way we can earn revenue, so for this revenue we can improve our economic growth. So we can say it is one of the requirement, it is one of the tool for improving our economy. In a developing country like India, trade policy is one of the economic instrument. In country, while trade policy we considering it is an instrument which are used to suit to the requirements of economic growth. Why we consider it is an instrument means by using our exports, we improve, by using our trade, we export our goods. For these exports, we receive some money. For that, we can improve our economic growth. The twin objectives of Indian trade policy, they are twin objectives, means two objectives. What are the main objectives of Indian trade policy? Have been promote exports. We have to promote exports and to restrict imports. We have to promote more exports and we have to restrict. Restrict means we have to make some restrictions on imports. Means increasing exports and decreasing imports. This is our main objective. The basic problem of a developing country. What is the basic problem of a developing country such as India? Developing country means India is also a developing country. So the basic problem of a developing country such as India happens to be the domestic non-availability of certain crucial inputs like industrial raw materials, machinery and technology. This is the basic problem of our developing countries. What is the basic problem? There is an unavailability of raw materials, like there is unavailability of inputs. What are the inputs? Like industrial raw materials, machinery and technology. This is the unavailability of instruments like industrial raw materials, machinery and technology. So we can say it is one of the basic problem for developing country because of unavailability of such inputs such as raw materials, industrial raw materials, machineries and technology. Though in the short run, imports can be financed through foreign aid. Why we are importing the goods? Because foreign trade, we are exchanging from one good to another country. Because of non-availability of these goods, we are importing these goods. In long run, imports must be financed by additional exports. While compared with the short run, it is okay, but in the long run, we are importing more goods rather than exporting. Because of unavailability of these goods, our imports has been increased due to exports. So it is one of the basic problem of developing country, unavailability of inputs like raw materials through industrial raw materials, machineries, etc. For this in short run, okay. But while we are considering in the long run, the imports has been increased due to the exports has been decreased due to of unavailability of these materials. So, we can say it is one of the problem. Therefore, the basic objective of trade policy, what is the basic objective of trade policy, revolves around the instruments and technique use of export promotion and import management. For considering all these factors, we have to make an policies and procedures. Therefore, the basic objective of trade policy revolves means we have to verify it around the instruments and technique use of export promotion. While we have to produce those goods, we have to improve our exports and import management. We have to manage our imports and we have to improve our exports and we have to manage the import. This is one of the basic criteria for improving our economic growth. For using our own technique use, we have to restrict the imports and expand our exports. Therefore, the basic objective of trade policy revolves around the instruments and technique use. By using some instruments and technique use of export promotion and import management, by using some technique use, we have to restrict our imports and we have to improve our exports. Then our Indian economy has been increased. Domestic factors have been among the biggest constraints inhibiting Indian exports. What is the domestic factor means? There are so much restrictions while exporting of goods. So for reducing these instructions, inhibit means we have to reduce these instructions, we have to improve our exports. Domestic factors have been among the bigger constraints. Constraints means they are the limits. Means we have so much of restrictions for exporting the goods. We have to reduce our restrictions, then we can improve our exports. Next, the foreign trade policy acknowledges some of these constraints and offers initiatives to improve the business condition. Foreign trade policy is nothing but exchange of goods from one country to another country. He find out all these problems while we are the developing countries are facing some of these constraints and offers. They reduce some limitations and they give some offers to improve the business conditions. The foreign trade policy acknowledges means finds our problems what the developing countries are facing. They acknowledge the problems and they give some benefits to the exporting country. What are the benefits? They reduce our restrictions and also they encourage some of the factors. Later we discuss what are the factors the foreign trade policy are encouraging for developing countries. Up to now we discuss what are the importance and implement. Importance means we can consider foreign trade is one of the tool while improving of the economic growth. In which way we are improving our economic growth? While improving our exports and reducing our imports, that's why we can improve our economic growth. And also the main two objectives have to promote exports and to restrict imports. In which way, what is the developing countries? All developing countries are basic problem because of unavailability of some inputs such as industrial raw materials, machinery and technology. These are very important inputs because we want to produce anything. We need some raw materials, machinery and technology. Without this, we can't able to produce or we can't able to export. So for these factors, we are unable to export. So by using our own technique use, we have to improve our exports and we have to restrict our imports. In short run, the imports is okay. While we are considering with the long run, we are more importing more goods rather than exporting. That's why our economy has not been developed. Therefore, the basic objective of trade policy, what is the basic objective of trade policy? Revolves around the instruments and technique use of export promotion. We have to improve our instruments and technique use of export promotion and import management. We have to manage our imports and we have to promote our exports by using our own technique use and measures. Next, domestic factors have been among the biggest constraints. In our country, there are lot of restrictions for exports of these goods. For these also, we are unable to improve our exports. The foreign trade policy acknowledges, some of the constraints and offers. There are some constraints and offers. Foreign trade policy has giving some incentives for developing, for improve our business conditions. The foreign trade policy giving some restrictions, reducing some restrictions and giving some incentives for increasing our exports. What are the, let's see here, such as simplifying and streaming procedures. What is meant by simplifying and streaming procedures? Let's see here. According to the old bank report on the business, the report is given under 2015. According to the old bank report of business 2015, India ranked 126th in the world in trading across borders. Means India rank is 126th, reflecting like delays in moving of goods in and out of the country. How India is, that means, suppose we consider there are 210 countries, example we think around that 200 or 199 countries, India is 126th country, we are in almost last 50 place. According to the World Bank report on business 2015, according every 5 years they have to give reports based on our imports and exports. Recently, there is a 2015 report. India ranked 126th in the world trading across the borders. World trading means exchange of goods from one country to other country. India is the 126th rank. Why we are in this last rank? Reflecting like delays in moving of in and out of the country. Like we are importing or exporting, there is a delay. Like we need to export or import, there is some procedure required. Already we learned in the first in the second chapter, that is for exporting of goods and also importing of goods, we required some documentation, that is invoice, shipment, bill of lading. For this we have to submit to the customs office. For this documentation, there is a delay of in and out of the goods. For that delay, we are unable to export more goods. For that reason, India is on the 126th place. For that reason, the government has introduced the e-governance system, that is paperless. Like online, we have to submit all the reports, and in this online only the customs union will give permission for import and exports. For this, there is no delay for importing and exporting of goods. For that, we can improve our imports and exports. So this is the one of the main advantage in our country today we are enjoying of e-governance. Let's see here. The new merchandise export form of Indian scheme, that is MEIS, means the new merchandise export form of India scheme, which encourages paperless trade through online. It encourages through paperless, through, before we have to submit all these reports to the customs union, first we have to fill and it will take time. After that approval, we have to submitted to the customs union. The customs union in holidays, they didn't work. After they will check and they give approval. It takes so much of time. Further delay, our imports and exports have been reduced. While at present, we have to apply through everything on online. For this, we have to save time and we have to improve our exports. The new merchandise exports form of Indian scheme. The new scheme, what is? The new merchandise export from Indian scheme, which encourages paperless trade through online filling and uploading the documents for export and import. For anything we have to export or import through any way, through railways, airways or waterways, we have to submit all the required documents in the online only. Then the customs union will check and give approval for this exports and imports, so it take very less time. Such as online issue of exports obligation certificates, we have to submit all the certificates required for the customs union. Acceptance on mobile applications and 24/7 customs clearance. They are working into 24/7, means 7 days 24 hours at 18 major seaports. We have 18 major seaports and 17 air cargo complexes. Business conditions for traders will improve even further. So by improving the scheme, what is the scheme? The new merchandise exports from Indian citizen scheme, we can develop our e-governance without paper. Without paper, we can upload all the documents in online only. Then the custom service will work 24/7, means 24 hours and 7 days. We get clearance within hours, then we can export or import our goods in an easy way. There is no delay of documentation uploaded. So it is the best scheme for improving our imports and exports. It's provide the foreign trade policy. It is one of the, already he said, they provide some of improved business condition. It is one of the implement he do for encouraging our Indian exports. They provide one of the scheme, that is new merchandise exports from Indian scheme. Through this scheme, we are unable to upload through documentation. Just we have to upload through online mode. Then the custom service will give clearance and we have to submit some documents. For the submission, we get approval. Then we can export or import goods easily. So it is one of the implement which encouraged our Indian exports. What is the simplifying and streaming procedures? They simplify the procedure without going to the customs office waiting for the officers. We can apply through online only, then they get approval. So it is an implementation and streaming procedure. Our next, incentivizing service exports. They provide the next services, incentives for our Indian exports. For years, export incentives in India have been focused entirely on manufacturing. In manufacturing, our India get incentive support. They focus were rationalized on the grounds that merchandise export comprises 67.5% of Indian total exports. It comes down to 67.5%. The focus was rationalized on the grounds that merchandise means goods. Goods export comprises, it comes 67.5% of Indian total exports. While comparing to the Indian total exports, the goods are exposed were come down to 67.5%. At the same time, India is a bigger player in global commercial service trade than in merchandise trade. India plays a very vital role for service provider, not for the goods transporting from one country to another country. But India is the biggest exporter for service provider, not only for doctors, some other services which are provided to the other countries. The India's place, India is the biggest role for providing services to the other countries when compared to the merchandise. Merchandise means goods transfer, but services means India is providing services. So in services, India plays a very vital role. At the same time, India is the bigger player in global commercial services. In global commercial services, India plays a bigger role trade than in when compared to the merchandise means goods transportation. India provided services to the other countries. It is a bigger role. Furthermore, India is a net exporter of service. Further, it will be again increasing. India is the net exporter of service. India is exporting his services. If exports more services to the rest of the world than in imports, while we are considering the import services, the export services is more, but while considering in the import of the goods is more when compared to the exports of the goods. But according to the services, India is the best when compared to the import of the services. India giving more services to the other countries. Indian service exports in global market and need for incentivizing these exports for maintaining their growth. So India needs some incentives from the government for maintaining these services to the other countries. So they provide also incentives, means they give money for this, for our services. So it is also one of the implementation and one of the source for improving our Indian services. So what is their incentivizing service export? They are providing some incentives for our services. Let's see here. For years, export incentives in India have been focused entirely on manufacturing. Manufacturing means for so many years, we are mainly focusing on manufacturing the goods. The focus was rationalized. Now the focus was rationalized means we have to focus not only manufacturing but also for services. On the grounds of merchandise, the exports comprises means the exports comes down means from maybe more than 67.5, it comes down to 67.5 of Indian total exports. While it is 100, it comes down, merchandise comes down from 67.5. At the same time, India is, however, at the same time, India is the bigger player in global commercial service. India plays a very vital role in commercial services, means ideas that India is giving services, means they are giving doctor services like ideas or whatever the services to other countries. It plays a very bigger role. Furthermore, India is a net exporter of service. Further, it becomes a net exporter of service. It exports more service to the rest of the world. It exports more service when compared to the rest of the world. India exports more services than it imports. In this case, India plays a very vital role. India exports more services than it imports when compared to the goods. Indian service exports in global market and the need for incentivizing. India wants some incentives for continuing the growth. Means India is providing more services. For this, India wants some incentives. The foreign trade policy provides some incentives for providing the same services of India to other countries. So it is also one of the implementation and one of the tool helpful for importing our Indian services. It is mainly focused on incentives for export services. I hope you understand. The first is simplifying for import and export policy while reducing the paperwork, and all the work are through online documentation. So we have to simplify and streamline procedures. We have to maintain the same economic growth. The foreign trade policy has provided some incentives for the Indian trade services. This is the second thing. Next, wide range of services. What are the wide range of services? Let's see here. The service exports from Indian scheme, SEIS, means the service exports from Indian scheme in foreign trade policy covers a wide range of services such as business, communication, construction, education, environment, health, tourism, to recreation and transport, etc. What are the services? The service exports from Indian scheme. What are the service exports from Indian scheme in foreign trade? That is, policy covers the foreign, sorry, the service exports from Indian scheme. The service exports from Indian scheme in foreign trade policy. In foreign trade policy covers a wide range of services. What are the services? Business, communication. In the previous point we discussed what are the services. Let's see here. Such as business, communication, construction, education, environment, health, tourism, recreation and transport. These are all come under the services. These incentives under SEIS. SEIS means service exporter from Indian scheme will now apply to service providers located in India instead of just Indian service providers. Not only Indian service providers, but those who are providing service to India also, we have to apply the scheme. Then the foreign trade policy has give some incentives for encouraging that. So, wide range of services. For these providing services, the foreign trade policy providing some incentives.